Let's now find out what stories our North America Bureau is pursuing today with our News Bureau Chief, TJ Manotto.
Here are the latest stories making the headlines amongst the Filipino community.
Over in Los Angeles, the Philippine Consulate held a special dialogue with a Filipino family attacked in a fast food parking lot last May.
I described to them also the extent of assistance that we can provide within the limits of the applicable laws.
After the private meeting, they brought in community members and streamed the town hall with members of the Los Angeles Police Department to address their efforts in combating anti-Asian hate crimes. The town hall gave a chance for the Roque family to express their concerns about how their case was handled, from the initial release and delayed apprehension of the perpetrator, to the police officers who originally discouraged them from pursuing the case.
We were being dealt with questions like, oh, do you really want to continue with this case? It costs so much to have a lawyer. Are you sure you really want to do this? It sounds like it's going to be resolved within a short amount of time. So, questions like that were being asked by officers like you to us victims. And I feel like that's something that victims should not have been given in the first place. We should not have been asked those type of questions, because I think that's one of the main proponents of why a lot of these reports, lack of reports, are still ongoing.
Our goal is always to investigate these crimes to the fullest. And if you had a problem with an individual detective, officer, or anybody involved in this, then you could bring it to my attention and I will investigate it.
Law enforcement officials say the number of reported hate crimes remains at the same pace as last year. However, they worry that incidents are often underreported. They're urging the Filipino community to step forward to report not just crimes, but incidents as well. Still in Los Angeles, Phil-Am rapper P-Lo introduced some new hits by having an album release party at the popular Dollar Hits in LA's historic Filipino town.
So me and the team got together, we're like, yo, let's put some dope stuff together. Especially in LA, we want to get involved with the culture out here.
And it's staying fired up back late.
The 13-track album includes Stunna Anthem, for which he recently released a music video that shows him wearing a barong alongside the Jabberwockies.
I'm very excited for y'all to hear the new album. It's my best album of all time.
And those are the top stories amongst the Filipino community in North America. You can catch more of our stories online at news.abs-cbn.com/tfcnews and on the ABS-CBN News YouTube channel.